today we're talking a little bit more about Pythagorean theorem. And one thing that you may have heard before is kind of Pythagorean triple. It says that whenever we have non-zero whole numbers that satisfy Pythagorean theorem, we consider it a Pythagorean triple. So, you may have noticed on triangles, you know, if you have 3, 4, and 5, those work together to form a right triangle. 5, 12, and 13, these are some really common Pythagorean triples. And what's really helpful about this is if you notice that a Pythagorean triple is being used, it can save you a lot of time to fill in that final spot of our triangle. Now, not only that, but if we have any multiple of an already known Pythagorean triple, it's going to also be a Pythagorean triple. So here it says, you know, if we multiply 3, 4, and 5 by 2, we multiply them all by the same number there, we get 6, 8, and 10, which is also going to work to form a right triangle. So, pretty helpful stuff. We take a look at this, it says, find our unknown length in our triangle. Well, this is, we have 15, 20, we're looking for our missing side. Well, think about our common Pythagorean triples, 3, 4, 5. Well, it looks like 3 was multiplied by 5 to get 15. 4 was multiplied by 5 to get 20. And so 5 must be also multiplied by that same constant value there to get 25 centimeters. That is our missing length of that side. And we could use Pythagorean theorem. I mean, I'm not saying we can't. I'm saying that can save us some time. It says, find our unknown length in the triangle. Do the side lengths form a Pythagorean triple? So here, if we look at this one, well, it looks like to me, we remember our 5, 12, 13 Pythagorean triple. Well, it looks like the 12 times 2 gave us 24. The 13 times 2 gives us that 26. And so I would imagine 5 times 2 gives us 10. And so we have 10 inches, which would be that missing side. Now, we can confirm that with Pythagorean theorem here. 10 squared plus 24 squared, is that going to give us 26 squared? Of course, 10 squared is 100. 24 squared gives us, of course, 576. And 26 squared gives us 676. Well, if we do this, 100 plus 576 is 676. I said it, wrote something different. So yes, this is confirmed, Pythagorean theorem confirmed what we were already expecting because of our Pythagorean triple. So when we're solving for Pythagorean theorem, we always take that square root at the end. Well, we get a radical expression, and sometimes, well, it's not best to round. We might want to keep our answers exact. So let's take a look at this. It says, find the value of x, give our answer in simplified radical form. So if you look for it, you'll notice there's not a, or at least not a Pythagorean triple that I know, that will complete this, find our hypotenuse. So I can use Pythagorean theorem, 6 squared plus 12 squared equals x squared. This is 36 plus 144. Equals x squared. 36 plus 144 gives me 180. And so when we take the square root here at the end, well, we know we want the principal square root. We want that positive answer because we're talking about a length. But if we plug this into a calculator, square root of 180, I get 13.1464 here. Take a look at it. 13 point whatever there. But that's not what we want as our answer. We want to keep this what we call exact. If I were to round that to however many places, I'm still going to be rounding it because it's an irrational number. I want to leave my answer in simplified radical form also here as exact. So I'm going to just simplify the square root of 180. You can break this down to look at the prime factorization of 180. Or if you're like me, I like to break it down noticing a perfect square that goes into 180. I know that 36 times 5 is 180. I know the square root of 36 gives me 6. So, in simplified radical form, this is 6 root 5 meters. 6 root 5 meters. And it's sometimes helpful to put that 6 root 5 in parentheses so that no one realizes that or thinks that meters is up underneath our square root symbol there. So 6 root 5 meters. Here, we want to do the same thing, find the value of x given our answer in simplified radical form. Well, we know that 5 squared plus x squared gives us 10 squared. That's 25 plus x squared equals 100. When we subtract 25 from both sides, we get x squared equals 75. Take the square root. X is the square root of 75. And we do want to simplify that. I know that 75 is 25 times 3. So I can break that down to be the square root of 25 times the square root of 3. What is the square root of 25? It is 5. I don't know what the square root of 3 is. I leave that. I can't simplify that. And so x is 5 root 3 feet. Don't forget those units. I don't want anyone to think it's up underneath the radical. So yes, I did put 5 root 3 in parentheses. Finally, it says the aspect ratio of a TV screen is the ratio of the width to the height of the image. Find the height and the width of a 42-inch TV screen with an aspect ratio of 4 to 3 to the nearest tenth of an inch. The length, 24 inches, refers to the diagonal distance across the screen. So, let's draw a TV. So it says, aspect ratio is the inch. Okay, so the aspect ratio is the width to the height, so we can see this is 4 to 3. It's going to be pretty helpful to us, 4 to 3. All right, so I'm going to find what the ratio is for that x right there, 4, 3. Of course, a TV screen is going to be a right angle. And notice that missing piece. I'm looking at the ratio. I'm looking at that 4 to 3. I'm not worried about that 42 right now. I'm thinking about in this ratio, what is that diagonal? And this is a 3, 4, 5 right triangle. So when I go to think about TV screen where we know the diagonal is 42. Well, it's at this ratio right here. It's going to be 3 to 5. I'll use a different letter. Y, or my height, to 42. 3 to 5, H to 42. 3 to 5 equals H to 42. Here's my width. Well, it's going to be 4 to 5 equals W to 42. Once we're able to set up ratios, as we can compare the basic ratio to the actual TV. And so when I work these out here, my height comes out to be 25.2 inches. Of course, I'm working in inches here. Over here, 4 times 42 divided by 5. The width comes out to be 33.6 inches.